Hey, we want to welcome you back to another one of our videos here. I'm Jason Steger. This is Dr. Patrick Flynn. We've been having quite a bit of fun with some of these videos. And, you know, really our heart and our goal in the matter is to just give you all the information that you possibly could need to live healthier. To make healthy choices. Yeah, be nice to your body so that you can make healthier choices, live a healthier, happier lifestyle. And we want to thank all of you who've been contacting us at thewellnessway.info with all of your questions. We're continuing to process through those and bring up some more topics. And just love doing this. I have a great time doing this. And today the topic we're going to talk about hormones.
Female hormones.
Yes. Yes. The male hormone we did last week. If you haven't seen it yet, make sure you watch it all the way through because we're getting pretty creative and having some fun with it. So, you know, my wife and I do Bible studies together, and one of our favorites is Beth Moore. And Beth Moore does cater to women, but I really enjoy her insights on Scripture and everything. And I was watching one the other day and was really thinking about this whole thing, the topic of hormones, because she said, because she caters to women so much, she did a study and asked this one question to like thousands of women, what's the hardest thing about being a woman? And she gave, you know, like the 3, 2, 1, what's the third, the second, and the most important. And the most important, or the top, toughest thing about being a woman, they said, is having hormones. And I'm like, whoa, well, we gotta talk about that, because if you got thousands of women out there that are wondering about hormones, how to get them under control, we know in our family from personal experience that you've helped my wife in amazing ways to control it, to understand it. And believe me, I don't quite understand it, and I never will.
You don't want to.
I don't think God created us that way, but she don't understand me either. But hopefully today we'll be able to nail down some topics here.
And it's a very, very, very interesting topic. One thing that I think is probably the most interesting aspect of female hormones is, first, let's look at it as a worldwide population, how we view hormones. If you actually say to a young lady that she's going to have a menstrual cycle soon, it has a negative connotation. If you actually say that a woman is going to go through menopause, it has a negative connotation.
Right.
Yet every woman within a normal realm that hits 16 to 17 years old is going to go through a menstrual cycle. Every woman that roughly hits the age of 55 to 60 is going to go through menopause. And the sad part is, we look at those normal processes of life now as they're something bad.
Right.
And the reason why is because what's happening with the women and their hormone levels is they're becoming abnormal, and now can have actually a detrimental effect on them physically, but also emotionally.
Right.
And if you ever look at some of the biggest problems that come about, especially with women, it affects them so emotionally, it can affect them in their daily life with their husband, it can affect their daily life with their body, it can cause cancers, heart disease. Any condition you can actually come back with a female can relate to their hormones, because compared to a male, we have the same hormones that they do. They're just at a lot smaller amount than we have. Okay, we're at a lot smaller amount than they have. When a woman goes through her first menstrual cycle, her hormones jump up to such a high level that their body starts to go through changes. It's supposed to go through changes, okay? But if they change abnormally, boy, it can affect you in a very big negative way.
Let me just ask you this for my own personal sake, and maybe some of you out there are wondering, I wonder, what is a hormone? I mean, why is it that we have less and they have more?
Yeah.
And, you know, what does a hormone, why would God give us a hormone?
Right. Well, it's actually, think of it like a messenger, okay?
Right.
It tells certain things how to work or not to work, okay?
Right.
But let's step back and let's take kind of a look at a hormone itself, okay? We talked in the video last week, we talked extensively about cholesterol, which thank you for all the hits, and we love the questions we've been getting from it, because it's kind of a controversial video, but a very simple video.
Right.
But what happens is all hormones are made from cholesterol, okay? And we talked a little bit about how the fact if these women are going through such fat-free diets and low cholesterol diets and that can really affect them even building up proper hormone,
okay?
Some of the things that I have to start with, you can see I just grabbed a ton of files, and actually this is just from this week alone, that I have to deal with female hormones. And every one of these files actually has a woman that has imbalanced hormones. And what I mean by the word imbalance, that means they're either too high or too low.
All right.
Okay. And when they're too high, there's a negative effect, and when they're too low, there's a negative effect.
Yeah.
Okay. So when you look at that hormone, we first got to start with their basic diet and ask them, number one, do you have enough sufficient cholesterol to make those hormones?
Mm-hmm.
If you don't, you're going to be very deficient in those hormones.
Mm-hmm.
And you can see that a lot. I see that a lot in the age group from all the way from 14 to 40.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Because women are so ingrained that if they eat healthy, good fats and cholesterol, that they'll be fat. And they don't realize that it's actually the opposite. If they do not get good, healthy fats, they cannot produce our hormones for weight loss, which is kind of funny because what happens if you want to look at one of the biggest things that women suffer from having imbalanced hormones, is actually weight gain.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Yes, psychologically, you know, depression is the number one thing that affects it. And one thing, stat that I did pull out right now, which is probably one of the scariest stats. If we had 10 women in this office right now, statistically, 4 of those 10 women would be taking some form of antidepressant.
Okay?
Our moms, our teachers,
right.
Our nurses, doctors, all these women that are in our profession. You know, I always say, I don't want a woman taking care of my child that's on an antidepressant.
Right.
Okay? Because I said, it shows that there's an improper balance there.
Right. And what we know from watching television commercials on the antidepressants that we can take, that mm-hmm. what's like a, some of the side effects of the antidepressants?
Suicide. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And that makes a whole lot of sense.
Yeah. And when we bring that up, sometimes people get offended but that's the reality of it. It doesn't come from us. You can actually go on any of the antidepressants websites and you can read where they actually put what they found out in their own studies.
Right.
And what they're trying to do, they're trying to really compensate. If you're taking a medication for depression, if you're taking medication for PMS, or if a woman has problems with cysts or PCOS, which is just an abbreviation for a condition, or if they're going through different menopausal symptoms, the fact that they're taking that for one key thing, imbalanced hormones.
Yeah.
Okay. So a good way to start, obviously, is get yourself tested. You know, it's very simple. You can do a simple blood test. You can do a saliva test. There's many ways to actually get those tested. That is the key. Okay. That's a very big key. And you say, well, once you find out those imbalances, okay, what they've done now from a medical standpoint is they give you synthetic hormones,
mm-hmm.
okay?
Yeah.
But that has, once again, has a negative effect because you're not allowing your body's natural ability to produce hormones to maximize itself.
Right, because okay? Your body's going to look at that as something that's foreign to the body and have to do something different.
That's right.
Because God created our bodies to fix themselves.
That's right. Well, if you kind of look, the one really analogy that kind of is probably one of the most, scary ones that are out there is when women go through menopause, their levels are supposed to drop, but they're dropping at such a significant level because they really don't have much production themselves,
mm-hmm.
and they put women on what's called a hormone replacement therapy or HRT. One of the most popular ones is Premarin, okay?
Oh, yeah.
And the one thing that most women, it kind of floors them when I actually tell them, say, do you know where they got the name for Premarin?
Mm-hmm.
It stands for pre-mare urine. So they take a pregnant horse. Okay, they extract the hormone from their urine.
I know.
It's true. It's not. This is something you can look up. It's really easy to find out. And what happens is they put it to the form, and then they relay it to our body. Now, last time I think I looked at our wives, they didn't resemble a horse.
No. No, and don't ever say that if you're angry either.
Yeah, that's right. So, but the point being is the fact that that's the best options that we have for women. Or you put them on birth control, okay?
Yeah.
Which I really do find it hilarious that some of the number one side effects are infertility and cancer. Once again, ladies, if you actually are taking birth control, look at the effects that happen.
Right.
When you abnormally throw off a woman's hormones, okay, it can make a woman go very psychologically and very physically in the wrong way.
Right, right. And one more thing about birth control. If you're taking birth control and you're not married, you're not doing the right thing anyways.
That's
so.
Right. That's a good little plug.
That's right. That is a good plug. You remain faithful to your God, and then you can remain faithful to your husband.
That's right.
But that'll be another topic.
That's a whole other topic.
And we may even elaborate more on this hormonal thing, because as the questions come in, you know, let us know if there's some smaller issue that you, or one of the individual topics throughout the hormone video that you want us to touch base on. Don't forget to check us out on YouTube. Check us out on thewellnessway.info. For Dr. Patrick Flynn, I'm Jason Steger. Have a great day.